Hey everyone, it's username 404, and welcome back to part 2 of Let's Play Legends of Zelda the Minish Cap. Last time, the Picori Festival got ruined by that bastard Varty, and he turned Zelda here into a statue. And now we, as Link, the hero of time, have to save the day. Okay, let's go. Here we gotta head out the castle. Oh, I have a sword now. Yeah, apparently I got given it while they were talking and I didn't notice. So, yeah. still got to head out the grounds. Now we're in North Harwood. And now there are monsters out here. I believe these are Octoroks. If we keep heading down, you'll notice that the path is blocked by these guys from Ocarina of Time. And yeah, our path's blocked, so we can't get into Hyrule Town anymore. When I first played this game, I spent about 15 minutes figuring out where I needed to go to get out of this area. I was wandering around, just going, where the hell am I meant to go? I've been everywhere. There's no exit to this area. And I didn't realise, because I'm retarded, that you can cut these trees down, these shrubs down, with your sword. And yes, I am retarded. Okay, now we're in Lon Lon Ranch. These things, these mole duck things. Yeah, there's about 5 or 6 of them in each of them. And you can kill them when the first one pops his head up. And that's the quickest way of getting them, but you don't get as many rewards from it, so I usually just let them all pop out and then just dick on them. Ooh, heart. Oh, I don't need a heart, but yeah. We're at the point of the game at the moment that where it just tells you, it points out everything you've picked up, because everything's all new and exciting. Ooh, die. Yeah, see, that just killed him, and you only got 1 rupee from that. When if you let all of them, you get a chances of getting a rupee from every single one. More Octoroks. Right. Ow. Oh, it didn't hit me. Good. Yeah, these holes are completely useless until the second dungeon, I think. But we can go in them. Just sit in a hole. Bit pointless. Yeah, and here's where we're meant to have gone. The Minish Woods. So let's enter. I feel like I should tell you why I decided to play Minish Cap. I'd actually say it's one of my favourite handheld Zelda games, next to Link's Awakening, because that was one of the first Zelda games I've ever played. But I quite like this one because, well, one, you can roll, which is really fun, and it kind of reminds me of sort of the gameplay element of Ocarina of Time, which is possibly the which I think is the best, and a lot of people think Majora's Mask's the best, but they're wrong. Yeah, these are the I can't even remember what these are called now. It's unimportant. They're rubbish. I'll learn it tomorrow. I'll tell you later. Yeah, so we just head up here. We can't go down here because that's too small for us to go in. So we've got to go up here. Kill these. And soon as you get to this water, you'll hear someone crying for help. And it's a duck hat? Yeah, it's a duck hat. It's a duck hat. But we're not going to go help him straight away. We're going to go over here and get our first heart piece. Okay, now let's go back and help the duck hat. who's all the way back here. We didn't notice when we walked past it earlier. I love how Link's just standing there watching it. Just like, no. I'm quite enjoying your suffering, Duck Hat. Yeah, just kill them. Move on with the storyline. I was sent here by the king. Would you believe that? Yeah, apparently he can read my mind. Because I'm not sure he's noticed, but I am Link. I am a silent protagonist, which is the best protagonist of all. Yeah. Okay, this is Ezlo. And he's going to be following us. So, let's go, Ezlo. Yeah. What? Okay, I'll walk. Why do you want to come along if you can't even keep up? Oh, come on! Screw you. No need to have a fit. Oh my god, no! I've got some sort of symbiotic relationship with him now. I think, yeah. It's quite comfortable. He's essentially straddling my head for the rest of the game now. It's just to point that out. Quit your squat. It's so much more wrong when you realise he's an old guy. Yep. Nice. Way to break the fourth wall there. Nice one, Ezlo. Fuck, you couldn't even walk without me. You're hopeless. Ugh, foliage. Yeah, head down here and he'll give us his first bit of advice, which is to stand on a tree stump. This is the main focal point of the game, where Ocarina of Time had time travel and Link to the Past had traveling between light and dark world. This is the ability to shrink. Yeah, it's not as good as time travel, or as, yeah, but it works. So hop on here and he'll say something in runic, I don't know. And this cutscene, which annoys me because it happens almost every time you do that and there's no skipping it. Well, to me it seems exactly the same, but Link's a lot smaller. Yeah, any bit of water now we can't go in, even like the shallow water, because that's now like a massive ocean. So yeah, if we went up there we'd die. Yeah, but now we can head through these tree stumps. Now we have to jump on these lily pads to get across. Yeah. Yes, I am retarded. I am retarded. Okay, and jump off. And here we go. I don't understand why they have this bit. Because surely the whole journey here as Link as a Minish would have been like that. But yeah. Okay, let's head on. Head on into the Minish village. Where we're instantly swarmed by these imp-like things. Ugh. Yeah, and they're Pokemon? Gotta catch them all? I don't know. Yeah. We've got to learn to talk like a Pokemon. They're blocking off all the entrances to all the buildings, apart from the one we need to go into. But first, we're going to go north up this path. And that's where we need to go, but we're going to go up here, along here, and get our second piece of heart. Yeah, it's four in this one. Four piece of heart for a heart container. And like, what was it? Twilight Princess, where it's 5 for some reason, where they just decided to change it for that one. Yes, yes, I am human. Where did you get glasses from? Festari. I don't, yeah. Yeah, we need to get a thing called the Jabbernut, which is something, it sounds like something, yeah, it is some similar to something from Hitchhiker's Guide, but it goes in our mouth, not in our ear. Yeah. Right, where we need to go now is down to this barrel here. You can go through the south entrance, but this is the quickest way. Down here. Yeah, they can talk. They talk. No, they don't talk normally because we haven't got... yes, I am retarded. I am retarded. And here we have the easiest block puzzle in the game. Oh my god, it was so hard. And here's the Jabbernut. So what we're going to do, because we're Link and we're the hero of men, we're just going to fucking steal it. You're going to steal it, eat it. And now we can talk to these guys. And they're not even mad about us stealing their shit. Because we're Link. We can do whatever the fuck we want. Okay, let's head back up here. Yeah, we've got to go back and talk to this guy, I think. Yep. Yeah, we've eaten it. We stole your shit and ate it. But he... Right, Elder. Yeah, these guys have useless things to say. Yeah, you just said what he said. Get some originality, says the person playing the Zelda game. Yeah, we need to head up here and talk to this guy. He's the big head honcho. I say big head honcho. He's the small Minish. Yeah, yeah, he's not very tall. Yeah, Ezlo's just gonna talk for us. He turns Link into the non-silent protagonist, which would be a speaking protagonist. Oh, why am I so retarded today? Yeah, he tells us that we need to go collect 4 elements. Yeah. Much like in most Zelda games, you have to get 3 or 4 something before you can get the next sword, and then you have to do something else. But I can't remember if you have to do anything else after it, or it's just end game after the 4. It's been a while. I don't think so. Well, we'll see. Okay, head up here. Talk to this guy again, and he will clear the way for us to get to the first shrine. And here we are in Deepwood Shrine. Yes. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna end it off right here. Don't forget to leave a comment and subscribe if you want to see more. Yeah, I'm username 404, and thanks for watching.